Look, I know everyone is disappointed that Hogwarts Legacy wasn't at the Game Awards, and trust me, I get it. I'm disappointed too. But I think there is some pretty significant news that dropped the day of the Game Awards, and not enough people are talking about this. So it's very possible that you completely missed it, but I think it's a pretty big deal. Retro Raconteur here. I'm just a dad who loves games and the stories they tell, and trust me, you guys, I am definitely right there with you. I never in a million years thought we would go the entirety of 2021 without virtually any significant updates regarding Hogwarts Legacy. You know, after they delayed it so quickly in 2021, it was clear we were going to be waiting for a while, but I really did not expect this. I completely get if you're frustrated. I completely get if you're disappointed because we all wanted to see a new trailer, and there were some things leading up to that in the day that made it seem like it was actually finally going to happen. There's absolutely still a ton of opportunity to build hype and to get that marketing campaign going, because I definitely think there will be a significant marketing campaign behind this. We did just see that they finally hired a community manager. I already made a separate video on that, so that's one thing that's going in the positive direction. But right now, I really think it's the silence more than anything that bothers the fans. So if anyone from WB or Avalanche happens to watch this video, we don't want you to rush. It's not that we want the game rushed at all. It's nothing like that. It's just we want to feel on the inside a little bit. We want to get some updates on the progress. I mean, after the game was first announced, at least we got tweets from the Hogwarts Legacy account. Now, they didn't even tweet enough to where they had their verified checkmark removed. This was actually a thing, you guys. They caught it over the Harry Potter game subreddit. There was a moment, I think somebody went back and looked, where it was like 1 year since they had last tweeted, and they hadn't tweeted anything at all, so they lost their verified checkmark on Twitter for a while. But it has since been restored, so that's a good sign. But for fans of the game, it feels like it really just doesn't exist right now, aside from a small interview comment here or a concept art tweet there. Now, all that being said, in the beginning, I did say we actually got some significant news the day of, in addition to the fact that a community manager has been hired. But this, I think this is even bigger than that. Developer Sumo Digital had a tweet go out the morning of December 9th, so the morning of the Game Awards, and here's what it says. We are very excited to share the news that two of our studios, Red Kite Games and Sumo Nottingham, are involved in the upcoming Hogwarts Legacy video game. And then a second tweet would go on to say, they've been hard at work with the teams at Warner Brothers Games and Avalanche Software on a magical new adventure under the Portkey Games label. So, for one, I absolutely love Sumo Digital. They did a phenomenal job with Sackboy: A Big Adventure. It was one of my favorite games last year. My son and I had an absolute blast with it. But I think the majority of people that worked on Sackboy were part of a different studio. That being said, they're all part of Sumo Digital, so they share resources and I'm sure have a lot of back and forth. But if we want to look at the two specific studios that they mentioned here, Red Kite Games and Sumo Nottingham, we will find some interesting things. So first up, this is the Sumo Nottingham game page right here. You can see some of the games that they've worked on. Texas Chainsaw Massacre and Hogwarts Legacy, both currently in development. Then you got Forza Horizon 5, major game right there. Forza Horizon 4 for Steam. Hotshot Racing, admittedly, I'm not familiar with that one. And then Team Sonic Racing. So a couple of quality titles right there that they have had experience working on. And then if we scroll through Red Kite Games' website right here, you see that they worked on Control Ultimate Edition, Mafia 3 Definitive Edition, Battletoads 2.0. Hospital, even God of War 3 Remastered, among a handful of other games. And so I think the interesting thing that we can draw from this here is that these are two studios with clear experience behind them, and experience working with major IP that companies like Sony entrusted them with working on something like God of War. Now, I know it's just like a remaster or definitive edition, whatever you want to call it. Then with Sumo Nottingham, you've got the Forza games. I mean, that is absolutely huge. Now, when all of that news broke, we got an additional tweet from Sarah Longthorne, who works with Sumo Digital as a narrative designer. So we're going to pull up her tweet here where she says, well, here's my first AAA game announcement. I hope those who choose to play feel our collective efforts to deliver something that entertains, inspires, and delights, but also welcomes and respects all. Some additional tweets. I've worked with some truly incredible people. I can tell you now, they really care both about others and about making this game the best it can be in all respects to the best of their ability. And then the final tweet from her, and since it caused so much speculation before, yes, this is the game referenced in the 30 under 30 listing, though others are yet to be announced. Now, credit to Sarah, she was actually trying to answer some questions from fans, not revealing anything about the game, but she at least responded on Twitter. Here's one from Ben White who asks, is there literally anything you can tell us? We've had radio silence since the reveal and it's breaking my heart. She says, wish I could, but no, I'm sorry. Anything new you will hear through official channels first. Now, I don't want to completely assume here, but if you look in her bio, it says previously Hogwarts Legacy. And then just going from the way that she talks about the game here, it sounds like she's talking in the past tense, as in her work has wrapped up. Now, if she's a narrative designer, that would certainly make sense. Hopefully, you would, at this point, you would hope that all of that would be in place and done. Now, I'm not going to take that and speculate any further from there about how far along the game is or where they may be, but I will just say, from what she's saying here, it does seem like her portion is at least complete, or the part that she worked on with Sumo Digital. And there was another question on Twitter that kind of got to this a little bit. It said, I know you can't talk about the game, don't want to get you in trouble, but I don't think this hurts the game, so I will ask it. Did you write from the start, or did you and the rest of the studio join Avalanche later in the process? She says, sorry, I would love to answer, but I don't think I'm actually allowed to go into that right now either. Ask me again post-release. So it probably wouldn't be something that she could comment on. So now, guys, I know it's not as extravagant as a new trailer, but to be completely fair, we did get some news on the day of the Game Awards, and I think this is significant. So when you take the news about the community manager, combine that with this, things are certainly moving in the right direction towards a marketing ramp up. And to me, I love the fact that we have two very experienced studios here who are involved with the project. And I will do a little bit of speculating here because I think this speaks to the magnitude of the game. Now, back in May, we covered the dev interview of one of the Hogwarts Legacy developers who worked on the sound design for the game. And he talked about just how many people have actually worked on this game. Now, unfortunately, that interview was pulled, and it seems like he probably wasn't supposed to say as much as he did, but one of the things that came from that interview was he talked about just how many people are working on this game. And so that's where my little bit of speculation comes in. I think it speaks to how big this game is, the fact that they are needing significant help from outside Avalanche, outside WB Games, and we know WB has a number of studios that could be working on this and helping out as well. We may not even know about all of them yet, but now we get this announcement of Sumo Nottingham as well as Red Kite Games involved with the project as well. I think things are certainly moving in the right direction. And as I mentioned before, if this is a holiday 2022 game, as most of us have expected, there are plenty of marketing opportunities throughout next year. Look, I'll be honest with you guys, we have to keep in mind that WB is a huge company. They have incredibly talented marketing folks. They've seen these trailer numbers. They know the power of Harry Potter. There's also that possibility that PlayStation has some sort of marketing exclusivity with this, so that's just another layer of planning that would have to take place between multiple companies. Now, I also want to address that rumor that WB is possibly concerned with backlash related to J.K. Rowling and how they may be worried about how much attention they want to draw to the game. Look, I'm not going to lie to you guys. I think it's certainly on their radar, but I'm not sure how much I buy this particular rumor given just how heavily they're promoting this HP reunion event and Fantastic Beasts 3. We got a Fantastic Beasts 3 trailer coming. By the time you're watching this, the trailer has probably already happened. So it's very possible that maybe they don't want to show it at a gaming event where they feel it might not be as well received. Perhaps instead they show it at some sort of Harry Potter themed event instead. And as I said numerous times last year, I think there's a great marketing opportunity for 2022 just to be an incredible year for the Harry Potter franchise. So we know Fantastic Beasts 3 is hitting in April. The marketing is really starting to ramp up for that. Maybe they use that sort of March-April timeframe as kind of a springboard into marketing for Hogwarts Legacy after the release of Fantastic Beasts 3. Heck, who knows? Maybe they even show the next trailer before the Fantastic Beasts 3 movie. How incredible would that be? Of course, it would be posted online and all that, but that would be a great opportunity to get the trailer directly in front of Harry Potter fans. So I know we're all frustrated. We all want to see more. We're all kind of down and sad because everything was pointing to the Game Awards and it really seemed like it was going to be there. But I remain encouraged, guys. I honestly do. With the passion of those who have spoken out about this game, and there's only been a few, but for those who have been able to talk about the game, the passion that they speak about it and how excited they are for people to play this and for people to check it out, that gives me hope that it's going to be well worth the wait. And I expect that we're going to start to hear more about the game in early 2022. Trust me, given the parties involved and the power of the Harry Potter brand, there will be a significant marketing push when the time is right. If you want to stay up to date on all the latest Hogwarts Legacy news, theories, and discussion, then check out the playlist on the left side of your screen. Or if you're in the mood for some old school Harry Potter Let's Plays, check out the playlist on the right side of your screen. As always, thank you all so much for watching. I'll talk to you again soon.